Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm doing fractions, adding and subtracting unlike fractions. So when we talk about unlike fractions, we're talking about fractions that have different denominators, so they don't have the same denominator. All right, so in the first two examples, I have 3 14ths minus 3 sevenths. They have the same numerator, that doesn't matter. What makes them unlike is when they have different denominators. So these definitely have different denominators. So what I want to do is I want to find a common denominator. Now, some people have always worked their their fractions to vertically, and some people do them horizontally, and I think more people do them vertically. So I'll show you vertical, but I usually work them horizontal. So that's an adjustment that you'll have to make, or work them the way you want, and you don't have to do it the same way that I do it. 3 14ths minus 3 sevenths. What you want to do is find that LCD, or least common denominator. What's the smallest number that 14 goes into, but 7 also goes into? And that one you might see pretty readily is 14. They're both going to go into 14, so that's my common denominator. The 3 14ths already has a 14, so the 3 doesn't change. But in the second fraction, there was a 7 here, and I changed it to a 14, which means I multiplied that by 2. And since I multiplied the denominator by 2, I have to multiply the numerator by 2 as well. 3 times 2 is 6. And now I want to, I want to add those together. Sorry, I want this to be an addition problem. And should have been addition, because I don't want to run into negative numbers here. And so I have 3 plus 6, and if I add 3 and 6 together, I get 9 fourteenths. Now, what does that look like horizontal? Well, what I would do here is just say between 14 and 7, what's the LCD? The LCD is 14. I just write it one time, because I'm just going to write it one time in the answer. Then I say, what about the first fraction? Well, the first fraction doesn't change because it already had a 14. What about the second fraction? Well, the second fraction had a 7, and I would have to multiply that by 2. So I had to multiply the other number by 2, and so I have 3 from the first fraction, and I have 6 from the second fraction, and 3 plus 6 is 9 fourteenths. Same answer. It looks a little different in how we write it. This one requires less writing. That's probably why lazy me likes it better. Okay, now I'm going to do the second one. I have 1 half plus, that one should have been a minus, but we'll just leave it as a plus. It doesn't matter, the minus or the plus, really. We'll leave it. So now this is a little trickier because I don't have numbers. I do have numbers, but my second number is a variable, and I don't really know what that is. So I can't do anything there except put the two numbers together. So 2 and x is going to be my LCD. In other words, 2x, and I'm going to have a 2x here. Now I go back and say, well, I didn't used to have 2x. I just had a 2. So what do I multiply 2 by to get 2x? Well, I have to multiply that by x. And so I have to do the same thing to the top. 1 times x is x. Remember, it's 1x, but it's okay to put the 1 in there or not. And on the bottom one, I have x. I have to multiply by 2. X times 2 is 2x. 3 times 2 is 6. And now I'm ready to add those together. I still have my common denominator of 2x. That doesn't change. And on the top, I have 1x plus 6. Remember, we can't put those together. All we can do is just say, okay, I have x plus 6 or 1x plus 6, whichever way you want to write it. And then I'm just done. I can't cancel anything there. I can't do the x's, can't do the 6 and the 2, because they're not separated. They're part of a bigger thing. They're a bigger expression. So that's all I can do. That would be my final answer. All right, what about something like number 3? And some of these are a little stretch for those of you that are just coming into algebra. I want that to be, I don't want it just to be, oh, more fractions that we've done forever. I want you to think a little bit about these. This one I'm going to do horizontally, so it's going to be this method. So I'm going to say, what's the LCD for 2, 4, and 16? Well, the first number they all go into would be 16. And now I'm going to say, what would I have to multiply 2 by to get 16? Well, I'd have to multiply 2 by 8. So I have to multiply its top number by the same thing, and 8 times x would just be 8x. What about the second one? Well, 4 times what would give you 16? 4 times 4, and so I have to multiply by 4 up here as well, and x times 4 would just be 4x. The last one already had 16, and so I wouldn't multiply that by anything. That would just be 2x. And so my least common denominator is 16, that stays. And then on the top, I'm going to add up all of the x's that I have. I have 8 and 4 and 2. That's 12, 14 x's. And I still have my LCD of 16. But I can't leave that because 14 and 16 can be reduced. I can do it on my calculator. Like if you just, every time you get that, just want to check it. Go 14, your fraction button, 16. Oh, yeah, that's 7/8. Oh, you can't see that because of the glare. It's 7/8, believe me. Okay, so that actually turns out to be 7/8, but there's that x in the top that I can't leave off. So 7x over 8. Kind of interesting and cool with the x's and the variables in there, right? Okay, the last one I will do vertically because I'm alternating or trading off a little. When I have 5 and 9, the common denominator here is going to be 45, right? And so I just multiply them together. That's how I got that, the least common denominator. I'm going to have to multiply 5 times 9, so I have to multiply 4 times 9. I've got to multiply 9 times 5, so I have to multiply 5 times 5. And when I add those together, my least common denominator was 45. And I add 36 and 25 together, I get 61. But oops, can that be reduced? I just don't think so. But I can jump over to my calculator, hit that 61, that fraction button, that 45, and I get 1 and 16 45ths. It didn't reduce it. I still have 45ths. It changed it to a mixed number. That's not reducing. That's just a mixed number. So no, it didn't need to be reduced. Finally, what if it says find the difference of two numbers? A difference means subtraction. So this means I know I have a subtraction problem. Whatever is stated first has to go first. So it's actually 4/5 minus 2/3. If they ask for a difference, they're asking you to subtract. I'm going to use the horizontal method. The common denominator for 3 and 5 is 15. Have to multiply 5 times 3, which gives me 12. And I have to multiply 3 times 5, which gives me 15, and so 2 times 5 gives me 10, and I'm subtracting 12 minus 10 on the top, which gives me 2 15ths. Adding, subtracting, same method, but you want to make sure you have a common denominator. All right, have